A recent report ranks Utah second in the nation for the quality of our bridges. And that's not luck. As a result of several road construction projects and a very active bridge management program, Utahns should feel incredibly safe when driving on our bridges.
Overall, our bridges are really good. I think we are the envy of a lot of the nation.
There are more than 3,000 bridges throughout the state of Utah, and on any given day, teams of UDOT inspectors are out giving dozens a thorough exam.
And you really don't notice a bridge unless you're really looking for them, because we do anything from 20 feet long to several hundred feet long.
We're about 50% of our time, you know, throughout the year, we're out inspecting. Days, several, you know, a lot. We spend a lot of time out of the office. We go out of town 1 week a month to hit like southern Utah and some of our outlying areas. And then we spend a lot of time, the other 50% spend in the office compiling reports.
Those reports detail the condition of each bridge, including a grade, good, fair, or poor. The main goal is safety, to spot any deficiencies before they become problematic. The other objective is asset management. We need to know the condition of each bridge.
So they're still, as they're working their way across, they're looking at all the girders, the underside of the deck, hammering on some of the columns, just checking for delaminated areas, which is concrete that has a void under it, but it hasn't detached from the unit itself yet.
Only about 2% of UDOT-owned bridges are classified as poor, but that doesn't mean they're unsafe. That's just a trigger for our engineers that those structures need to be addressed.
It's just hitting a category that to us internally is telling us, hey, we need to do some work on this bridge to either increase its life or possibly look at replacement just because it's hit the end of its serviceable life.
Inspectors work on a schedule that hits each bridge every 2 years. But even if they're not specifically inspecting, they're always on the lookout and need the public's help to spot potential issues.
I just know that if my family is driving on a road and over a bridge, I want it to be as safe as possible. And so I think the group kind of has that same feeling that we want to keep it that way for anybody that would be on that bridge.
Of the 13 bridges currently listed in poor condition, all are set to be addressed in the next 4 to 5 years. That doesn't mean our job is done. Our bridge inspectors will be out there every day ensuring safety and making sure that our bridges are in top shape.